All right, you're our life. So good luck and have fun.
Thank you. Good time zone, everybody. It's good to have you with me here as we are going through what I said before is Furi, the... Oh, hold on, wait a second. Yeah, Temple of the Void is good. All right. Furi, which is like a retro experience in terms of the synthwave. If you can't hear it here, the overwhelming 80s music that is going along with this for a soundtrack. You're a prisoner trying to escape and trying to figure out what in the world the story is as you battle your way to the surface of the planet Earth below. Looks like planet Earth anyway. But yeah, the best way to actually describe this is just to put you in it. So that being said, let me get started here. Let me drag this over and make sure we have the dono window open so I can catch everything that happens when it happens. And this over here. Yo, Pachi, how'd you miss it? Wait, how you guys doing the transition? Don't worry about it, it's magic. Magic. That being said, let's get the story started. Richard Chambers, good to see you. Welcome home, both of you. Two of my wonderful adventurers here with us in stream today as well. Exactly. Magic. Oh, I should probably check the controls to make sure that they're the right set that I'm supposed to, but...
You were a weapon, a bringer of death, and now you're nothing. I will keep on killing you, again and again. I am your future. An eternity of slow, painful death.
I mean, this sounds like the type of thing that you'd want on a Halloween, right?
Peter Petter. Time to wake up.
I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying right here with you.
So now, one of the brilliant things about this...
Shake your head. Nod your head.
The storytelling is actually really quite phenomenal.
See what they did to you?
Oh, did I miss it? Dono, hi. Wait, who, what, when, where? Sean, thank you so much for the dono.
Get out of prison.
Best. Hold on, here we go. Best charity stream ever. See what I did there? Freedom. The first dono. Yeah, the music in this is so hype. It's so dope. It's so freaking awesome. If you guys have seen ever... any of the 80s synthwave stuff, everything about this screams it. Screams it. Breathes it. Personifies it. And you know what I love the most about this? You can just have it go auto. Hold on. Before we go anywhere, I need to make sure that these are actually set the appropriate way. Great, we're good. Controller scheme D. Resume. But, I mean, it gives you time to kind of just take in the scenery as the voice. The guy in the rabbit head tells you what is going on. And you try to figure it out. Now, the first boss fight tends to be more of a tutorial to try to figure out what in the world you are doing. Because they just kind of toss you into it.
You listen to me, and you listen good. You'll never escape.
And as you can see here, every echo world down there shows you which boss fight that we have to go through, as everyone has just been alerted to the fact that I escaped from my cell. There we go. All right, so as you can see here, we have slicing with the sword as a basic attack. We also have the ability to dodge, shoot things, because it's a bullet hell, and make charge shots as well. So, first phase is always just kind of figuring out what in the world the boss is doing. And as you can see here, you get a little glowy ring, and then you go into close combat. Now, as close combat tends to be, it's very quick paced, and if you mess it up, you get hit. So, explaining the very basics on that. Let me get the parry, hold on. You have to actually do what it tells you for the first section. kind of punish them, and then it resumes with the fight. Now, every boss has different health bars, and they kind of keep the same between having a red health bar and a blue health bar. Go through the blue, you get to the red, and then they lose one health, which is not that great because they have infinitely more health bars than you. Alright, what do they want us to do this time? I forget. Charge slash, alright. BagofTrix, you don't have the ability to exploit character abilities. No, no you don't. You have to actually play this the way that you need to. Now, every particular boss fight has their own characteristics in terms of the way that they gloat, the way that they give opportunities to attack, and the way that they prefer to attack. So, every different time they lose a life, you have to go through a different phase. And each phase consist of maybe something just a little bit different or something a little bit more than what they had before. So it's kind of really much a learning experience. I'm gonna play Shita Kamuro Churro if I get through this, Pachi. That's the if. Yo, Ryofuka, welcome home, my friend. Oops, too early. Come on. Neon Swagger. I don't even know what that trophy is. Third phase. Fourth phase. They really hurt, don't they? Well, that was nothing. I'm gonna teach you some real pain. Alright. More bullet hell. All the little green orbs are actually health ups. And now, as you can see, we're tossing in different things from each phase as they finally start the actual battle. And every time they decide to stop and talk, you can just take it out of their faces. Let them know. This is the first boss. Yes, this is the first boss. I don't think you've ever gotten the chance to see this, have you, Ryofuka? But him compared to everything else later on is absolutely nothing. Oops. Hold on. Come here. Ah, shoot. He's our warm-up fight. Alright. You really want to play this? Alright, so. Now, there is one thing that you can do that's really high risk, high reward, is if you go ahead and charge it up, you can take your ability to the next level, and instead of having to fight them three times, you can take them out in two hits. Right there. So this game is 90% bosses, correct. 90% just action. 10% storytelling. Come on. Oops. Hold on. Did that wrong. Where are you at? Alright, this guy has a boomerang, and we're still good. Ooh. Perfect! You know, the boss doesn't realize that you've beaten Cuphead and Undertale. Bullet hells mean nothing to you. You know what? Then you would do well here. But unfortunately, it's not just a bullet hell. As you'll see, a lot of it comes down to parrying and timing later on, and aiming. Aiming is good. But anytime they do a big move, you can just punish them all day long. Now, he has two more lives left. The last phase, I don't really consider to be a life, but this means he gives us the ability to just take him out here in one more shot. One more phase, and then it's the kill phase. Where are you at? You know what? I'll take that even exchange. No, that was all should have been parry all day long. Nope, that's a bad one. God, those hurt. Why do those hurt so much? Now, the good thing about the range weapons is that you can actually... Ooh, nope, 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 nope. You can parry those, or... Ooh, give me that help. Give me that help. No! I don't want to do this phase over again. That's also the hard part about this, is if you lose a life, you start the entire phase all over again. There we go. Now, can I do this without getting hit? Nope. Entire phase all over again. So, as you can see, it goes back and forth. Now, they get all of their health back. So, as you can see, back into the blue. And then you have to kind of take them down again. So, to get good or die. Actually, don't know what that is. I don't think I've ever seen that before. But again, leaves himself wide open to attack. The Dead Cells main character, you know what? That's actually a very good comparison. Which one came out first, though, I wonder? Oops. Alright. Let's do this right. Come on. There we are. No! He actually dodged that, you little prick. I just want to charge attack you. Are you gonna give it to me? Alright, three. And open. And decides to talk about it again. Now, I did not take the charge attack, so you can see now it's taking three different attacks to be able to take him down. And then for this last health bar, I get my health bar back. So now I'm back up to three lives, but he has only one. Now, he starts a pattern of only having to take him down once for the first, like, three or four bosses. And then it becomes more complicated after that. But as you can see now, we turn into just straight up a bullet hell section. Where you have to worry about all the trash in the room. And if you can survive everything that he puts out, then you get the opportunity to kill him. There we go. And it's just easier for me to stay in the middle than it is to try to go anywhere else. But as long as this spreads out a little bit, you can kind of just keep on going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And there we go. Alright. This is it. Survive through his final attacks. And then as soon as he tires himself out, because every time he's glowing like that, he's invincible. And now, he's dead. And then you get a cutscene and more story. That is the first boss fight for Furi. And it doesn't disappoint from here. In fact, it just becomes more and more intense. See, you say this one's easy. And I dare you after this, if you haven't gone through Furi, try Furi after this.
You will be broken. You will go back to yourself.
To hell I won't. For sure. Yes.
Excellent. What a thrill. Not your first time, right? Anyway. The good news, we're one step closer to freedom. The bad news, there's more out there waiting for us. But don't worry, I know them. I can help. Believe me, what's waiting at the end of all this,
this guy
is so worth it.
The bunny helmet is nightmare fuel. You know what? Honestly, he's so suspicious. And the way he tells you this story,
way down there lies a free
makes
world,
everything a world of peace, so suspect.
Where you're free as the wind. And you know what? We're going to get there.
From the beginning, this guy does not seem trustworthy. And every step that you take further to your goal just raises more questions about the guy underneath the rabbit hood. Not to mention, watch as you travel. Pay close attention to the guy who's in the rabbit outfit. The voice is his name as he tells you a story and appears out of nowhere. Look at him.
But don't expect all the answers. It's all about what a man does.
It's Donnie Darko, 100%. That's beautiful. And again, ahead of you, not riding on the platform, floating everywhere.
That, my friend, is a prison. A prison within a prison. A very clever trick.
Look, Mom, no hands. Auto story mode. Just freaking creepy. He appears everywhere in front of you, never traveling with you.
She turned up one day, destroyed everything in her wake, and then bam, she got caged.
It's Fast and Furious. Oh, I see what you did there. Too bad I don't even have the button open right now. But yeah, it's really kind of nice, the dichotomy they give you between fast-paced action, nice slow storytelling, and that lovely downtime. Wait, is that Mark Hamill? That's a good question. Look up the voice actor for the voice in Furi. Furi. One little section. Now this next boss in particular,
she tried to tear through those walls so many times, but they just kept growing back.
She's a little rough the first time that you get to her.
It drove her completely insane, enraged.
Because she really is crazy. I'm glad that you checked the stream. For some reason I thought that you'd stream 1 hour later. I guess you don't have daylight savings times yet. We are on daylight savings time, Ryofuku, currently, until the weekend, this coming weekend, not this one.
We know that so well, don't we? That's why we did what we did. That's why we're getting out. That's why our story doesn't end like hers.
But isn't it just so ominous? Now, the dynamic and the trick between everything inside of here is that she is absolutely insane. The next boss that we are going to fight has been driven mad by her cell, trapped within these walls that just keep on rebuilding themselves with no one left to murder. And thus, she's isolated and left alone. But it's also quite insane and easy to manipulate because of the fact that she attacks anything. Here we go. So she's not too bad at the beginning. But you can use the middle pillars and the circle things in the middle to actually distract her so that she gives you free hits. And it's not something that you want to use and abuse in the beginning because it's more useful later on. Ooh, that was bad. her first phase is actually really kind of easy. Hold on. Come here, girl. Come here, girl. Because she's still in her straitjacket. There we go. And an instant kill. Second phase. I forget. Oh, yeah. She adds these little tiny balls of doom. As well as the rando shots. Oh, crap. Now, those ones, we cannot actually do anything other than reflect. And if I really wanted to, I could reflect those as well. And that just gives me a free attack opportunity. Anytime she decides to stop and take a hit onto the other cells. Try to reflect it too late. God, it actually gets easier later on now that I think about it. Alright. Easy enough. And we should be charged for an instant kill. There we go, second life down. Aww, isn't she a happy girl with her scythe? Aww. Now, one thing I'm not really adept at that you can do is perfect counters. If you parry something perfectly, you can actually make it into an attack of opportunity, but unfortunately, it's precise timing. The most precise timing that you can get with this. And it's only very few times that I can actually pull it off. But some bosses require it. Come here, girl. Alright. Next attack phase. Ooh, right. Almost forgot about that. Alright. This gives us a free kill. Alright. Now this time she adds in, I think, one more type of projectile. Ooh. Hold on. There we go. Better to just parry. Or I could actually go in and take it for a attack of opportunity. And this was the one that gives me... If I had waited one more second, I could have gotten over there. What are we doing? Good. There we go. Perfect parry. Alright. If we time this right. Ooh, missed that odd. Never mind, she's gonna glow. Giving us the ability to send her right into her melee phase. What are we gonna get? Perfect. Oh! We missed the opportunity to get her and kill her in this next phase. Instead, we are going to have to do it in three hits instead of two. Don't mess up. She actually gave it to me. Nice. Now, for the fun part. I said she's insane, right? Would you try to free yourself with an energy scythe that can cut through metal where your feet are bound? I wouldn't try to do it. The opportunity of accidentally missing and slicing off your own feet is a scary enough prospect. Yet, here she is, not really caring. only thinking about the fact that she wants to murder the person who's come and traded your territory. But we gotta find her. If we can lure her out in the open. There she is. Hey, girl. All right. This is where things get a little bit more dicey. As we are one phase away from her last phase for the kill. You know, if I can aim better today, that'd be nice. But as long as she keeps running right into the bullets, it's totally fine. There we are. Melee phase. Alright. And here's the big question. Can we actually pull off the charge and get the insta-kill? Is she gonna give it to me? No! I accidentally ran right into that. Alright, one more love tap. One more love tap. Bring it home. And now the favorite part. Two days of training was worth it. Make it look easy. I mean, going through the hell of trying to figure out how to do this for 2 days? Yeah. Yeah. And then she's almost gonna break through this tower, and then at that point, we have to kind of just make sure that we don't get hit, take our life back. And then we have to survive all the garbage she throws at us, one thing after another, for at least the next, I think, 30 seconds of all of this. I'm gonna get closer to her because it's easier for me to dodge through. Shoot. Crap. Alright, melee phase. Alright, are we gonna be able to get this? We just have to wait for her to throw everything that she possibly can. It's like an animal caged in a corner trying to fight for its life. Doing everything she possibly can before she dies. And there it is, the second boss. Shocking, isn't it? The girl's tossing, launching Kamehameha waves like crazy, trying to kill the person who's come to kill her.
Well done. You put her out of her misery.
And I threw it on the ground. That ain't my cell phone. Wait, that ain't my dad. That's a cell phone. No, that's a crazy lady who just got fried on an electric panel.
Put her in a cage. Then you came along and they did even worse. Way worse. It all went so wrong.
But she turned into a pickle. Oh, ooh, oh. Oh. Well, I'm visualing that in human pickle. Fried on an electric panel. Oh, jeez. That ain't a cell phone. That's my dad. It's okay. Cause I just threw it on the ground. It's what I do to my dad every birthday he has. I just, you know, instead of giving him like love taps for every year older he is, I'm gonna throw you on the ground, okay, Dad? Okay. It's fine, right? You won't break a bone. It's not like you're like 80 or almost. God, I don't want to think about that. Thinking about time passing by and the fact that your folks get older every year as you get older every year. and watching them age as you get older is sometimes a depressing thought.
Feel it? It's like a dream.
And that's why we're here to say, fuck cancer. Because if they're going to go out, at least have them go out of old age. Speaking of dads, you know, your dad's getting old now. He's like 68. Mine's like 73 or 4.
The real world is somewhere else,
so
down there.
I kind of don't want to think about how, in the future, how much longer people might end up living when technology advances to a point. You know what I mean? You're 21 and, you know, you broke some bones. At least you're at an age where you can still get that back. And as long as you didn't break them in a way that makes it detrimental to using the limbs that they're attached to. But hopefully you're okay, though. Your dad's still 41. It's okay, you got time. Take your dad out to do all the things while they can still move and experience life the way that you can still experience it. You know? Except for the whole broken bone thing. Don't do that. Now, the next boss here, as you can see, it kind of has a...
There's more to him than meets the eye.
Kind of has a Zen garden feel.
A master of time, so they say.
Because it
if
is.
He's such a master, if he saw it all coming, why didn't he do something about it? Why didn't he stop it from happening? Or at least warn me? But look where we ended up.
I mean, breaking bones isn't fun. Let me reword that. I'm sure that there's somebody who likes breaking bones as some sort of weird martial arts thing. Having your bones broken is not fun. Therefore, doing it to other people is a no-no. Unless they're assaulting you.
Play cool. Easy for him. He chose to be here. But we are definitely not cool with this.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. I'm never watching Jackass. Never, ever, ever watching Jackass. I saw one clip of Jackass when I was a kid, and I looked at it and went, why would anybody want to watch this? I don't want to watch people suffer from stupidity. That is not my cup of tea.
Time to move on. Go cross his path, my friend. The jailer is the key.
Jackass is something else. Jackass is what happens when you give people a camera and say that, hey, if you do something that looks painful and is kind of not smart, you may get money for it. And you'll be surprised the people that take that to the next level. Now, this particular boss fight messes with time in a couple different ways and makes you take time. Makes you wish that this wasn't the way that it is, but it is.
Welcome,
unfortunately.
Stranger. I have been looking forward to this moment.
It's a fight that mainly tests your patience and basically the ability to read moves.
I foretold your escape, but not how far you would get it.
Have I seen 1,001 ways to die? I have not. I don't even want to think about 1,001 ways to die.
I can't kill you, but I can remove you from my here and now, capture you and bring you back until the next cycle.
And this I don't understand. The cycle. Card Shark, good to see you. Welcome home, man. Another brave adventure from my stream coming over here. Oh, hold on. So everything that you toss at these shields gets tossed back at you. And I could theoretically reflect it, but we're going to make a couple different openings here. And then try to use them.
You live under Oops. The illusion of control. Abandon the fight. It is written.
Alright. And then we just kind of circle around, put a couple dents in his shield, and then when we have the opportunities.
Your
we break through and punch through. We only need to make one entrance to be able to make this work. It's breakout all over again. Oh god, I missed it. Alright, hold on. Wait for the opportunity. Alright. Ah. Missed that one. But we get that one. No! I thought I had a full charge, but apparently I didn't. Take that one out. Oh my goodness, my gigantic window is on the other side. Come on, please, let me through. Thank you. Jake's is messing up. Shh. Not badly, though. Oh, man. I mean, at the very least, I haven't made a gigantic pool of garbo mess. Look at that, we still have the two in the middle, we just need one to break it down. There's one. Ah, close, but no cigar. There it is, there's our opening. Oh, by a hair. There it is. Alright. Now with this, I'm just going to deflect them, if I can actually get that right. All of them fails. Ooh. Hold on, I need to remember how to do this phase again. There we go. Now we kill everything that comes out, and then as soon as we can break that down, then we get our bullet hell phase. Alright, we just need to go ahead and grab as much health as we can. Just wait for him, listen. There it is, there's our bullet. We just need to make sure we can grab him in there. There we are. This guy's got balls of steel, man. Nope. Hold on. We'll grab this. There we are. And I forget if I do get a melee phase with this. Crap. Hold on. There we go. And free hit. The question is whether or not I can get the charge for an insta-kill. Charge is up. And if I do this right... No! Crap. Crap. I messed that up. It was so close, but I messed that up. Now, as you can see here, actually deflecting the shots when they come up makes it a bit easier. Come on, come on, come on. That is my heal.
It's not looking good.
There we go. Crap. This is actually where things start, for me, I think, getting hard as a boss. And this is probably one of the ones I've actually had the most practice on, too. Alright, wait for him. There it is. I'm just gonna go grab a couple of these. No, come on. I might end up having to do this again. Oh. No, so close yet so far. Yeah. The timing on him compared to everybody else is so much different. I don't want to have to do this all over again, so we're going to make sure we get this next one and do it right. There we go. Just kind of a back and forth. There we go. Alright. It's almost like he controls time. Just a little bit, right? Alright, wait for the sound. There it is. Can we space that out just a little bit so we actually get the full tumble attack as well? Wait for that. Take it. Alright. Melee phase. I feel confident enough that we actually should be able to finish this. There we go, and if I get this right after the second one, we should get ourselves back to two lives. Yes. Yes. Yes! There it is. Two lives. Instead of one. Alright, I gotta remember what this phase is. Oh, yeah. Alright, hold on. Timing on this. And now we gotta watch out for this bull. Alright, here we go. We wanna take out as many of these as we can. And then wait for the sound. Nope, missed that one. There it is. And inside of here, one thing that I can't do is use projectiles, because everything is frozen in time except for you and him. If you use projectiles, you actually end up making a detriment to yourself more than anything. Alright, alright, alright. Take it. Alright. Should be able to know I missed that one. There we are, nice. Now can I get the insta-kill? If I get it, it puts us back up to three lives. There it is! Three lives! Oh, I don't remember this one. Right, okay. It says the dodge everything in his trash phase. Now, you can, if you get into trouble, decide to parry stuff. But it's more prudent to just dodge. It's like Piccolo in his training camp. If there's anything you're going to take away from this, just remember, dodge! Seek joy in these last breaths. Now, you got to take out every single one of these. As they go ahead and give you more and more garbage. As time goes by, things get even worse. Just dodge. Exactly. If you don't keep an eye on the bullet hell, now every time you take out one, another phase of madness gets added. Jeez, freaking hell. God, so many bullets. So much hell. Oh, jeez.
Hold on, 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 hold on.
Okay, alright. Freaking hell, I think I gotta wait for the sound. There it is! Holy balls, man. There it is. One hit left from having to do all of that over again. Good morning, Nedge. Team 4-star reference. Nice. Exactly. Why would I not make a reference to that? As he tries to rewind time. It was so close. One little bullet peg, and I would have had to do that all over again.
Look to the sky, stranger. Therein lies your answer.
Bye-bye, old man.
There is no fate. We build our own destiny.
And again, story time. Hands-free controls as he walks towards his future.
He knew a lot. He even figured out why you were sent to us. Look at the sky, he kept saying. The dot on the sun. But no one listened.
I actually don't think I caught that last time. Between the reason why that the stranger, you, the person going through in Furi, was sent to, I think, Earth, and why you started murdering everyone. Oh god, this fight. I am not looking forward to this fight. I literally spent about, I want to say, 8 hours of my life learning this next boss fight. Trying to figure out how to do it and not die in the second to last phase.
My friend, years of evolution, culture, civilization, great intellect, wonders of nature. Bam! Wiped out.
Just test. Wait, no. Wait, just homework, no test for about another week. Never grading. Grading never ends. It's true. You remember this, right? Remember how long it took me to get through this? Do you remember how long it took me to figure out what to do for this boss fight?
I searched and searched. A solution, an answer, anything. Just some hope, you know, that I could fix this. Fix him. So my plan would be flawless.
And we still don't know enough about Rabbit Dude. The voice.
But I never found a thing.
This was my worst boss fight. Hands down. This one. This next boss fight. Learning how to take him on. And having to change my preconceptions about what I needed to do.
Rolled up in a ball,
was the worst.
Cried for the rest of my days. And left you frying on your rock. But I didn't.
So many questions.
I don't know much about you. I've heard some bad stuff, and what I've seen, well.
The worst.
But
brought
we have
worst.
One thing in common, you
60
and
Simon's not all too bad.
We
I mean, you should be able to knock that out by this afternoon, right, Nudge?
Every day we're
yeah?
locked away up here. We have nothing. We've lost. One thing about Fishface up there, you know, he got, contaminated. I'm not sure he's got much to say. He probably can't even speak at all anymore. But if he does, just ignore the crazy babble.
Just ignore the crazy babble, he says. And yet some of the stuff he says about you as the main character is quite interesting. You'll have it done before lunch. Nice. Here's Freaky Fish Guy. Oh, hi. Hi, Mark. How you doing? Now, one of the beautiful things about this fight is you can actually start it off and smack him in the face because he decides to talk. All right, I gotta remember what to do for this. Right, we can actually go right in and punish him fairly easily for a lot of different things. And if we can dodge some of the attacks, we can go right in. Oh, right. We can't do that part. Crap. Crap. I might actually mess up this one. Yeah, I think I messed up this phase. Am I gonna be able to get my life back? Let's see. Nope. There it is. Yo, James versus games. Yo, this game is hiding. Listen to the music. Listen to the music. And then listen to your heart. Alright, one of the worst things about him is the fact that he causes you to lose your senses every time you get hit by one of his projectiles. Which is why the screen goes all wavy. If you're wondering. But you can reflect his projectiles as well. Right. Nope. Couldn't grab that. Should be able to grab that one, though. Alright. Melee phase. Easy enough. Take a quick hit. And if we get lucky, we can actually grab the insta-kill. Yep. Ho! And it's mine. Sim on your feet. Gonna have to buy this. I've been having a good time learning Furi, and I don't normally venture into something like this, but the music and the storytelling is so phenomenal that it makes you want to do it. There's a lot of just knowing your placement and staying your ground. Now, there we go. Nice. Melee phase number two. If we can grab this. GG, easy kill. Shh. No, it's not over yet. All right. Insta-kill, maybe? Insta-kill! Wait until the last phase. Yeah. I don't like that last phase. Oh, crap. Hold on. Third phase. I need to actually pay attention. There's a couple of different things that we can take off on here. There's so many opportunities for us to attack that if I play my cards right, we can do it. All right. This is why I like the third phase, because it is opportunity central. All of his attacks are big, giving you the opportunity to just smack him into the ground. Except for this one. Magic soldier. So much power, but so much. Oh, hi, Freaky Fish Guy! Alright. Oops. Shouldn't look at the chat. There we are.
Come here. Take that one, do like this, watch back that, and he gloats, giving us the melee phase. Can we get an insta-kill? Well, no, we missed the first opportunity. Alright, is he gonna gloat? He doesn't gloat, but he gives us the opportunity to... No, I missed it. We might actually lose the third phase. I'm gonna take the opportunity. And if we dodge this next attack, we can go in there, we take off at least half of his health. And then we can get him with a normal attack, and that's all we need to finish the phase. Ooh. No, come on. Is he gonna gloat? Is he gonna gloat? No gloat, unfortunately. But, we still get the kill. Now this, fourth phase is where everything starts to get a little bit more dicey and you get introduced into the freaky fishman territory. Oops, oh, I did that wrong. Come on. Where's my opportunity? 2, 3, 4, 5, hit. It was a close one. Managed to pull it through though. Hold on, wait a second. Nope, still didn't get it. Oh, freaky fish guy mode. Alright, 1, 2. Oh, I think I might actually lose this phase. Yeah, there it is. I took way too many hits. So we gotta do this all over again, hold on. But if I do it right, it should be a little bit easier. There we are. Second one. I think we need 1.5. Ooh, look, a free hit. I love it when he just sits there and talks to me. Come on, talk dirty. Talk dirty, man. You're in the sewers. Freaky Fishman time. Oops. Uh-oh. Did that wrong. We gotta get through all of the different clones before he pops back up, and if we do it right, we get an attack of opportunity going through, because he pops up in the middle right here, and bam. Now all we need to do is shoot him to death. If I can aim, yeah. Crap, it was this. This is what freaking screwed me up. Alright. Insta-kill. Nope, lost it. Crap, man. Can we dodge one more round of attacks? Nope. Crap. I hated trying to learn through all of his stuff. It's okay, you didn't jinx it, it's fine. Kind of. At 1. You didn't jinx me, it's fine, I promise. Now, the reason why I choose to do that instead of deflecting is because if you do not perfect deflect on that, all you do is get health back. And I want the damage, and he gives us a free attack on that. Bleed the fit. Somehow I don't trust your fit. Alright, freaky fish guy. There's another one. Now, one of the things with this particular phase is that it takes a lot of precise aiming to pull off the attack, so you can easily just overshoot. Oh, right.
Thank you. Thank you for giving me the attack of opportunity. All right, hold on. Wait a second. Thank you. One more. And let's see if we can't get the insta-kill. Insta-kill! Two lives left instead of one. Alright, this phase is actually probably his easiest in terms of the most deceiving phase out of all of them. Because when he does that, you can actually charge right in and slice him up. Because it's a big open move, and he does it a lot. But he still sticks with his normal motif of going in with the multi-strikes. And he just doesn't shut up! My friend, learn that gloating gets you nothing but death as you turn into Freaky Fishman. I hate this face. And at least he does this one instead of the pulses, which makes it a little bit easier to survive. Oh, crap. Alright. There it is. We need to shoot him up just a little bit and he'll be done. Ready? Crap. Crap, 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 crap. I screwed all this up. Mistakes were made. Is he gonna gloat? Is he gonna gloat? He's not gonna gloat. Crap. Crap. This was the phase that repeatedly killed me. Alright. I'm not gonna try to go for the insta-kill, but he is gonna gloat, giving us the opportunity to grab a free attack. If we can just grab one more. One more, we go into the final phase. We get it! Nice. Instead of two lives, we now have three. Three attempts to get this final phase. Started out with a really bad one life phase. Holy crap, man. Alright, now this is the thing that killed me, I think, a bajillion times. Going through and trying to figure out how to do this. Oops. And now everything gets all wavy, and my freaking sense of direction is actually quite horrible. Ah, see, it makes it just even harder to do this. Yeah, I lost that phase. Alright, we'll try this again. Mel's over here actively betraying us. Jinxing everything. Alright, now I need to stay out of the middle. There we go. Oh no. Crap, man. I just keep on taking the wrong hits. Alright. Now, if I can... Nah. It'd be a shame if I lost. It would be. But, you know, maybe I'm making this for dramatic tension. Maybe this is all just my plan to make it look like this is actually very hard. Hold on, give me a second. I cannot read chat during this phase. Alright, now Freaky Fish Guy starts off giving me the third degree into this. All right. We can kind of just stay in one cell if we kind of... Oh, no. I lied. Everything about this is a lie, and now I have one hit left. Oh, God, I got to live through all of this. I just got to survive all of that until he gets tired, and then going for the kill. There it is. Holy frickin' balls, and there's a reason why that took me 8 hours to figure out and do. It's actually super easy. You know, just do it perfectly and don't mess up. Gino, you're right. I should stop messing up. Card shark. Yes.
Will we share his fate, or will life take an unexpected...
So far, every single boss,
hope
first time.
From the strangest places.
Fourth boss down, on to the guy who put us in prison.
I thought about it for so long.
Hey, don't tell him it's your first time playing this particular title. Shh. Don't worry about it. I'm not telling anybody. If you tell people, they'll be surprised. Because I actually didn't practice at all. No, I'm just kidding. Too much practice.
I will free myself. Whatever the cost.
And as we're getting dark into here, seriously, the most shady person out of all of this is the guy in the rabbit head telling you the story. It just makes you think, makes you wonder, and I don't know. But this guy here, I feel bad. I feel bad for what we're about to do. Legitimately, if this was me and my choice, I wouldn't do this. I would probably do something far worse than what we are about to do, because I feel bad with the way this goes down. Anybody who knows what's coming up,
I know,
might feel
hard,
the same way.
But when I am struggling to keep faith, I think about the beauty of the world beyond. It keeps me focused. It keeps me going.
Man. Who's the boss after this one? Was it the song? Was song next?
You were captured, thrown in prison.
The rabbit leads Alice deeper into the rabbit hole.
Finally, you escaped.
This rabbit is probably not one that I would want. Imagine if the rabbit from Alice and Rabbit and Wonderland was this guy.
Just waiting to throw you back in.
Do you think she would have followed him down the rabbit hole?
How does that make you feel? They didn't kill you already because they can't. Believe me, they would if they could, without blinking. Second best for them now is to put you back in chains.
See, but then why would you help him get out? You know, what is the driving motivator for this guy?
The anger. Good. Focus on it. Let it grow.
That is a sad rabbit. What is it? That's sad. Freaking, it looks like a Pikachu morphed with a Pepe.
Let me tell you some more.
That's just missing its... No, it has his stripes. It is a Pikachu Pepe.
There'll be no stopping.
That's actually quite disturbing.
He is the one who got you here in the first place. He is the one who brought you down. He led the men who captured you. Hundreds of them against you. Is that fair?
You know, why does the bunny guy have a selfie stick? Because he's the voice, man. You can't walk around without a microphone stand.
So what?
Look at it.
An eye for an eye, huh? Time to take your revenge.
He's holding a mic stand the entire time. Prudish Duckling, good to see you. Welcome to the greatest party on earth, the Retro Block Party. Spooktober Vision.
Kill him, and you will be free.
Protein breakfast bar at 2:00 in the afternoon, Pachi. Are you just starting your day? I'm glad you guys could make it here for the stream, the Retro Block Party stream. I don't know if we're going to make it furthest than I've ever been, but you know what? We're on pace to probably be able to. There's a good possibility we could get past the next three bosses. That kid right there is what makes me sad about what we are about to do. That boy is about to become an orphan.
No courage.
I feel so bad.
From you. We are what we fight for.
You Got an energy drink. Oh, nice. Dude, I woke up and started your stream. Well, hey.
I look at you,
I appreciate it.
And I see nothing. Desolation. Death. You are alone. I am fighting for something much greater than this. Can you imagine the strength that gives me? I doubt it. And so your fight ends here.
Yeah. What we fight for. You know, so he has a kid. He has a kid that we are about to make an orphan. This fight is particularly tedious because of the fact that I cannot use projectiles at all in the first three phases of this fight. He reflects them. I just gotta wait for him to provide me with the opportunity to attack so that I can let him have it. Alright. First phase on him is really easy. Second phase is a little bit more annoying. Things just kind of pick up until he tosses his shield away, and you'll see what I mean here in a minute. But it's kind of like the guy's rusty and has had peace for too long before he starts picking up and he becomes like, oh my goodness. I feel like he's like Solar in Dark Souls. Alright, first. Second. Insta-kill. There it is. By the way, has anybody noticed that the main character is from the glorious PC Master Race? You can't use Bagmaster on here. It's not on this stream. Oops, crap. Wasn't paying attention, this is why I shouldn't reach out. Alright. So you see what I mean about him being slow at the start? And it really is one of those opportunity things where...
It's the right thing.
Where he really is just kind of a slow tank. Alright, one more phase. No, crap, I forgot that long tracking move. Oops. That was bad. Alright, first one. Insta-kill charge. Insta-kill. Oh no! Why did that? I didn't get a full charge. Oh, that sucks, but at least we still get our life back.
Go back while you still can.
Okay. Now, this is where things start to pick up.
You've given me the chance to teach my son an important lesson. That when good men look away, evil prevails.
Alright, first one. Good attack of opportunity. Shh, I didn't mess up. It was all of our practice. Now this, and then attack! Hello. Come here, buddy.
Surrender. You can't win.
Give it to me. You got one. We got two, and then a tag. Saturday's always cleaning day for you. What type of cleaning do you end up doing on Saturday? Another attack. And then here we are. Nice. Melee phase. Crap, I screwed that up again. Okay. He gives us an easy one. Now, for this particular phase, everything that he does that is a attack pattern where... Ooh, crap. No, I didn't charge. Crap. Alright, charging the insta-kill. Easy opportunity to go ahead and end it. We build all of this. Second to last life. This is all just a bullet hell, as now he's tossed away his shield and I can go ahead and have at him with my gun. But trying to do anything other than attack him with a gun or parrying perfect parries is futile, because he will break right through your defense, punch you like no tomorrow, and show you what it means to be a paladin or a berserker. You know, whatever you want to look at.
You can't win, stranger. You have nothing to protect, nothing to fight for.
Man, I don't want to do the last phase of this fight again. Oh, man. I don't like the last phase of this fight. Charging the insta-kill. Alright, got the one, two. After this, here we are, nice. Last phase.
I will never give up, stranger.
One thing that's beautiful is that inside of this, for the first hit, he becomes invincible, but then you can just take him out like that. And then everything you do afterwards needs to be on point. And if you fall into the garbage like I'm falling into right now, you get into big trouble because you take a hit. Crap, man. Yeah, that was bad.
For my son, for all of us, I am bringing you back.
Do this again. First attack. Hold on. There we are. It's just small movements, small movements, small movements. No, that's not what I was trying to avoid doing.
You can't win, stranger. You have nothing to protect.
Shoot, I screwed this one up again. That's over. So he's got two health bars left. Yes, he has two health bars left. We have to survive the onslaught in the beginning here, and then we have to survive the endless attack spree that he does. Crap. No. Oh, if I don't do the rest of this perfectly. Yep, there it is. First game over.
Is he going to bring you back? Come on! You can
it is literally the last phase that is actually really hard. Everything else before that is quite simple in learning how to dodge, learning how to do. There's a bag of treat for Trix. Aww. Are you going to treat me to some non-sabotaging? GG, I mean, yeah, you'll get it next time. Aw, don't worry. He's going down. I want to show you the other bosses. They are really quite interesting if don't miss my attacks. The one after him, especially, is really intense. Really intense.
I brought you to your knees once already, and I will do
concentrate.
So again.
Shoot. Alright, there's... No, I missed! Alright, we got this. There's one. Charging. Charge. Can I get the insta-kill? I can! There it is. First life down.
Go back while you still can.
And it's just kind of like, after fighting Freaky Fish Guy for 8 hours, his moveset is so much easier than Fish Guy's moveset, because he's so much slower. So much slower.
You're no match for me. Give up while you can.
And, it's the right thing to do. Good. concerned, and I wish that I could just take him out with some nice simple hits, but unfortunately, literally the only thing you can do is do the charge attacks. Everything else is kind of, oops, I should stop talking. Hold on. Ooh, hold on. Everything in close combat with him is a gamble. Shoot, I screwed that up. I have to do this in three.
Go back.
Come on, buddy. There it is. Second life down. Third phase.
While you still can. You have given me the chance to teach my son an important lesson. That when good men look away, evil prevails.
Oops. Wow, I screwed that up. Hold on, wait a second. Nope, there we are. At the very least, I didn't lose the attack. Very nice.
Surrender. You can't win.
Alright, this one takes two. And then, right in his face. Ooh, hold on. That might be the end of that phase for me. Hold on. I'd have to end up doing the next combat section perfectly and not get hit at all.
Surrender.
This might be a wash. Yeah, nope, it's over. This is what I mean by doing anything close combat outside of a charge technique is kind of just asking to get pushed over.
I am bringing you back.
Oh no, hold on, wait a second. That was bad. I forgot what phase I was in. Surrendering. Oh, actually, he just gave us a free attack on that one. Nice. I thought he was going to go for the second swing, but he didn't. And then one more love tap, and then we get our nice melee phase. Ooh, nah, wow, he did that completely different than I thought he was going to do. And I can't believe I actually managed to get that attack in. Ooh, crap. Crap. Thank you for giving me the easier one. Ooh. Are you only able to charge as close combat? Correct. Crap, I thought I was going to be able to do the one, but unfortunately we're going to have to make sure we just don't get hit. We are. Nice. Otherwise, I'd be using the charge a lot more to get more damage in.
All of this. Be prepared. Invested so much.
And like I said, there's no point in actually parrying unless you can do a perfect parry for all of his attacks. Because otherwise, you just waste every opportunity you get to just keep on laying more damage into him.
You can't win, stranger. You have nothing to protect, nothing to fight.
All right, melee. I thought you weren't going to read in the middle about a trend. You know what? Not for this part. I won't anymore. How about that? And right behind him. Charge for the death kill. Oh, nope. He's slacking out of it. Shoot, man. We'll take the three hits instead of the two. No, that's fine and easy and nice. Enough of the final stage. I just need to make sure that my movements are very precise. Otherwise, I get tossed into the green, and it's not a good time. We're going to actually parry some of his other attacks. Oops, that was a bad idea. Bad. No, crap.
You can't win, stranger.
There we go, nice. But I'm going to try to parry the melee attacks, I think is what I ended up doing before. Crap. There it is. Final phase, I gotta parry everything. Every single attack. No! So close. He only had four more. Oh, jeez.
I will never give up, stranger. The stakes are too high.
Daigo Evil Moment 37? Daigo Party. No. I don't know what you're talking about. Ooh, hold on. Here we go. Small movements, parry. Crap, he went and freaking did that one.
You can't win, stranger.
It's so nice of him to pick you up. I mean, he was going to take your corpse back. And he had ulterior motives. There it is, melee phase. There it is. Oh, hold on. Wait a second. All right, hold on. Crap. All right. Yes. All right. I got it. All right. There's one boss that you have to actually charge to kill. And this wasn't the one. I'd forgotten about that for a second. Ladies and gentlemen, that kid is now an orphan. I feel horrible. Oh, man. Let's go, GG, let's get it, man. Abso-freaking-lutely. I feel like trash for making a kid an orphan. Seriously. Oh.
Man, that was intense. But you've got to move on now. Don't overthink it. That's what they want you to do.
Adopt him, like in Yakuza. Kazuma-san would have. Absolutely.
You
should have picked another job. Oh, yeah, man. You know, the kid can just follow you around. Oh, no. There is nothing more scary than a kid with a vendetta and a knife. I mean, he's a weapon laying on the ground in the form of his father's blade and a shield. All he has to do is wait for the opportunity and you'll find it sticking in your back. Also, hey, welcome, Ares. Story time.
This one, upstairs. Arrogant, self-righteous, and cool. That's her. She started it all. She even got me locked up. You're going to see her little show out there. All this nobility and self-sacrifice. But really, she's just trying to clean up her mess. Just remember, she's messing with your head. Don't listen to her.
I'm sorry, this is the freaking synthwave. The next boss is the purest thing to a bullet hell that I've seen.
Anger, your instinct. You don't belong here. Give her a good kick from me.
It absolutely has a killer soundtrack. This is one of the reasons why I was allowed to play it, because of the synth wave. So really.
Walk with me.
Honestly.
It was all a mistake. The cell, the response.
I hate this boss.
My world. but you can be free here. Look at what I'm offering. This can be your home. I'll take care of you.
Seriously, this boss fight sucks so much.
I'll tell you the tales of my world. You will tell me yours.
Oh, it may have not taken me as long to learn how to beat her, but dear God, the amount of trash that you have to deal with in this boss fight. Have you tried asking the boss to be friends instead?
Stay with me.
Well, I mean, sure. Sure, I mean, this one kind of wants to be your friend. We could. Happy Halloween, Scarlet.
What's the big hurry?
But unfortunately, we have to piss her off instead.
Why are you leaving? What's not to like here? If you go any further, I have no other choice, and you even less than me. How dare you shun me and turn down all of this? You have no idea. I was your only hope. You have brought this upon yourself, stranger.
All right. Get ready for a wonderful bullet hell. This is an overly attached girlfriend gift. No. Oh, dear God. All right. I gotta remember how to actually do this. Give me a second. All right, so that one parry, and that one. All right, here we go. All of this. This is a load of bull. Everything that happens inside of this boss fight is nothing but bull. Alright, we gotta take care of that. Alright. And then she's gonna go ahead and give us the opportunity. There we are. I'm sad to wake up to that. Wait, wake up to what? Hold on.
Why so stubborn?
First life down. This is a different boss fight than most of them, as some of the lives that she has does not require you to take out two health bars because you can't melee her because she doesn't want to come into melee range. Crap. But you can fire her in the face whenever she gives you the big attacks of opportunity. Ooh. Ooh, give me that free health. I'll take it. Shoot. Oh God, I hate this one. Alright, go ahead and do this. There we go. Shoot, I screwed this up and she's gonna go ahead and take her attack. No, come on, we're so close. So close. There it is.
What could you possibly ask of me?
God, I hate this boss fight so much. Oh, trying to freaking learn how to do these sections was a pain in the entire rear. Ah, oh, crap. I'm probably going to end up losing this one. Yep. Crap. Yeah, there it is. Do this over again.
How hard could it have been? You ruined it all.
I don't know who that is, Trin. What did she play? What is she? Is she a singer? An actress? Or he? They? I don't know. I don't even know Javon. Anyway, hold on. Shoot.
You made me do this to you.
Alright, this one's a wash. Okay. Nope. I might have to do her twice.
So arrogant. How many times do I have to make you fall to realize I was right?
Crap. Crap, man. Oh my goodness. Just taking every single hit. There it is. I will read through that in a minute. This is one of the more difficult sections to actually be able to pay attention to chat, because there is so much garbage that you have to pay attention to. Crap! There it is.
Please.
Okay.
Don't give her the pleasure of victory.
Sean Connery played him in the original Highlander movie. Wait, hold on. Did Sean Connery die? Wait, Sean Connery died? Wait, what? Hold on, what did he die of? Holy crap, I did not see that. Wait, whoa, okay. News to me, he died about an hour ago. Was it Lady Rona? Old age, okay. I mean, sure, he was 90, but still. Anyway, hold on. Alright, I need to concentrate on this particular fight. Hold on. Because, like I said, there is so much garbage that you have to... start off the fight like that. And we are going to forego taking any of the healing items. Instead, we're just going to go straight up for the heals, for the damage. So we can... Oh my god, I missed. Well, I was like, we're just going to take her out right then and there. There we go. I like how it's an exchange firefight. Alright, come here, girl. Take my bullet to the face. There are a couple different split-second decisions that you have to make with this fight that just kind of throw me off every time. Crap. Didn't clear it out. There it is. Yeah, I screwed that up. Hopefully I can actually go through without taking another hit. There we go. Gotta concentrate. This should be it. There it is.
What more could you possibly ask of me?
This garbage. Oh man. Come on. Thank you. Except for that. Crap, so many hits. Alright. Take that free heal. There we are. She's gonna have to do her thing. Oh, crap. And she just keeps on going until you punish her, too. Crap! No! So close. So, Sean died. Sean died peacefully in his sleep while in the Bahamas having Aw. Haven't been unwell for a while. I didn't know. Crab. I don't want her to be a game over.
You made me do this to you. I didn't want to hurt you, but I will.
Come on. There we go. It was not a full charge, but at least I was able to stop her from doing her bowl. And I can just kind of shoot down the middle here. Come on. Let me have it. Crap. So close.
That's so arrogant. How many times do I have to make you fall before you realize I was right?
All right, we're just going to wait and hold out for the last one. No, she didn't do the wave. That was weird. But she did the wave right after that. Of course she did. Honestly, anybody playing for this for the soundtrack, I don't blame you. In fact, it's kind of like Sonic Adventure, how you just play the soundtrack just because it sounds so good. This might kill me. Oh, I got her. Nice. Now everything becomes a lot more complicated as she's actually doing a melee phase. And now she has two health bars. Perfect counter. But she leaves herself open for good attacks like that now. Crap. And now we have to try to face through her entire phases with everything and all the garbage she's tossing at us. Right.
You bring nothing but destruction.
Nope. I should not have tried to take that. No, I missed the entire opportunity that I had. Crap, man. And I missed that one as well. This is why I mean about precise aiming in all of this. Yeah. Crap. Release your bankai. I can't botch you. She's killing me, Smalls. Ooh, melee phase. There we go. And then, if we can try to charge for the insta-kill instead. No! Crap! Now we have to do it in three. Come on. She talked! She gave us a free kill. Holy balls, man. These next two phases, she mixes the melee with the range, and then she goes completely defensive in the last phase. Crap. Right. Is what I mean by, oh, crap, and the laser beam. I forgot about the laser beams. Always forget about the laser beams. There it is. Let me grab that health. Crap, I screwed all of that up. There's one. Don't waste your generosity now. I'm not trying to, man. Crap. I didn't know which one it was.
Now all I can do is bring you back into it.
There we are. Nice. She gave us a free one. I wish I could just toss her down off the cliff right now, like I just tossed myself. Come on. Dude, I got stuck on the bad side. Right. There it is. And again, with her, I always forget about the laser beams. Oh! So close. Crap, man. There we are. Cut her wings off. You know what? If I had common sense, I would probably do that, huh? You bring nothing but destruction. All right. I'll just go ahead and try to take that. Perfect opportunity. Final phase now, with the insta-kill being in the second one. Hopefully we can at least steal her Red Bull. Because they gave her wings. I see what you did there. All right. Now this, we have to kill the first one down here, and then we'll go ahead and make our way across the platform. Because doing it any other way is a pain in the butt, because you can't see. For every platform you kill, the more junk gets on the screen, and you have to dodge so much. Come the final pillar. Because this is her attempt to not die. Right. It's like the final desperate please. Crap, man. There we go. I curse you for making us go through this. You are so blind. Come on. Come on. Oh, God. All I gotta do is get in there. There it is. All the health orbs just, you know, flying away. I mean, that makes you think of Geometry Wars. It does a little bit. Eat you up inside for the rest of your days. We didn't quite make it through all of the bosses, but at least I'm gonna get to show you the next one here. Thank you, Prudish. Thank you, Otter. You think that for a second, maybe she's wrong. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm not doing this the right way. Maybe there's another way other than going and killing all of... No, let's just do that. Let's just take those wings. Man, I just wanted to ask for her number. You didn't have to do this. Sure I did.
I did not expect that. Not from you. I think I saw you hesitate after the last fight. You, of all people. Why would you ever hesitate? Made me think. I like it. It gives me hope.
Oh, man. He was just looking for the perfect spot to strike. Yeah, and just to take the wings. Got to make sure you carve them up like poultry, you know? Make sure you get right underneath the bone so you can take them and flap out of here. That's what this is. Like, and honestly, this entire next section just makes you wonder even more. Because he put on a show.
Oh, it's you. Well, I took care of this one. It was really tough. I'm no fighter like you, but I got my way. After the last jailers, I felt you deserved a little more from me. Call it my contribution to our escape. We're in this together. Now more than ever.
Nah. It's all a trick. I don't know if I'm able to skip ahead for that. No, not really.
By a genius architect. A perfectly designed masterpiece of a prison.
Have fun cleaning, Pachi.
Impossible. Passable prison. I tried so many times to find some way out of here. But there wasn't one. Except for you.
This is why I say that it really kind of begs the question of what's going on here.
I could have found a way out without killing them, without freeing you. But I couldn't outsmart my greatest work. Slowly, that ancient animal part of
where are we at? You're at $642 out of that goal for $1,000 raising for F Cancer. For those of you who do not know the donation incentive, if you want me to read something off to you in a movie trailer voice, please, if you make a donation, attach a message to it, I'll gladly read it off to you here before my end of my segment, as we're going through a little bit of story right now. But I'd say this is an awesome cause for this month of October, especially as we're nearing the section of the year where people tend to transition from different sicknesses. Where do you make a donation? Right over. Can somebody push a donation link? I think it's at the bottom of the stream as well. Thank you, Ares. I love the tiger button got there. There you go, Nedge. We got a little bit of time as well. How are bits handled? Did they also get donated? I don't know the answer to that question. Can somebody, Ahmad, answer that one for me? How do we handle bits?
She has a plan. On a scale of 1 to 10, she's an 11, and she'd give herself a 12.
Oh, there we go. Brutus Duckling. Thank you so much for the $24.32. Oh. Yes. Well, hold on. Let me grab this here for you.
Opponent armed. Graphene composite saber. Automatic laser handgun. Range 200 meters.
British duckling.
Capacity.
Great run, Trix. Let's continue to say, fuck cancer. Because that'll be the new movie for everyone to view this evening. The F Cancer stream. In which we solve the world's issues. And become one. The cure for cancer.
Remember, for her it's all a game. But losing is not an option.
I'll probably get a chance to show you guys through two phases before my segment is up. But at least you get to see this very, very, very cool boss fight in terms of how she's set up. And it's kind of a hide-and-go-seek process with a lot of trash and a lot of dodging.
Now you're mine. Go get him, boys. This is not a drill.
I mean, can you imagine sitting around at the jail cell just, you know, playing with your drones all day, waiting for somebody to show up? Sniper Sogeki. This is what I mean by there's a lot of, alright, we gotta find her real quick. And I think probably the most prudent way to do that would be to stand someplace where she can snipe us. Let's see, where is she at? There she is. Nope, crap. Come on. Shoot, I missed her. Wow. I'm just apparently gonna off myself today. That's my thing. There it is. With 1 HP. Oh man. Really? Am I really gonna have to do this with one hit? Nope. Of course. Time to play hide and seek, and it just did not go the way I wanted it to. We have to pay for web page computer upgrades for the stream as well as giveaways and etc. So I saw something about the giveaways, about that, and how that was to be handled if people were doing that. I was like,
this is fun.
That's what happens when you're not paying attention. If you get sniped, it's a one-hit kill. Crap, she moved already. There we go. There we are. Now we tagged her. Now we can actually resume the fight. This is one of the ones where if you don't get a perfect dodge or perfect parry, it's kind of pointless. But at least you can kind of keep your health up that way. Crap. What? I get distracted. Chat is my biggest enemy. Now, if there's a thing we can do, been done with bits and... Oh, wait, hold on, wait a second. We gotta get rid of these guys. Honestly, Richard is, that's more true than you know. I get distracted. I can't help it. Alright, now where's she at? Find me, girl. There she is. I'm probably going to die. No! Oh, there we are. Nice. Ooh. All right, there we are. There we go. Got ourselves some life back at the very least. You know what? Since this is going to be the last one anyway, since it's about that time, Nedge in here with a $20 donation. A great streamer. No, hold on. Wait a second. We can do this. I can do this for you. A great streamer. A great streamer. A great cause. My grading is nearly done and complete, and I shall salt my food with the tears of my students. Thank you so much for $20 towards fuck cancer. Because, you know, fuck cancer. Nobody needs that. Where's she at? Thank you. No, thank you, Nedge. There she is. Oh, shoot. I passed by her. Where's she at? Trix gets distracted. Squirrel! Hey, that squirrel did not deserve to be made into a distraction. There it is. Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing fine, and you? Have you enjoyed your segment?
I have. A little bit sad that I didn't get to show everybody everything, but you know what? It is what it is.
Hey, for the most part, I really enjoyed your segment. This game is really amazing.
Right? And the music is something else.
Yeah, it's really amazing. The graphics are so good. But anyways, we have to move on. And if you don't mind, I will pull in the MQ that is up next.
Yep.
If you don't mind.
No, go for it.
All right, let's go. Hey, what's up, DM? How are you doing?
Hey, I'm doing alright, how about you?
I'm doing fine, thank you. So, tell us, DM, What are you going to play for us today?
Well, today I'm going to play Mega Man X3. Well, I'm going to speedrun Mega Man X3 Bus 2 only. And then after that, we're going to go into the classic Doom with the Brutal mod used for the game.
Oh, that looks really hard to do. So, I really wish you good luck on that. And what about your Dono incentive? Can you talk about it?
So my incentives are $30 to force me to play on the game's equivalent of Ultra Violence difficulty level. And then, dare I say, donated up to $66.66 will go up to the very hardest unfair difficulty, which will be considered black metal.
Alright, looks really interesting. So, Trix, I'm gonna ask you to count up to three and go offline so DM can go next. Any parting words, by the way?
Fuck cancer.
Yeah, fuck cancer. I agree with that words. So, Trix, go ahead. Ready when you are.
Yep. One, two, and three.